everything has to be good enough. You know, nothing is probably going to ever be perfect, but, you know, maybe I can accommodate bad data or late data or a tool that's not quite right. So things don't have to be perfect. My knowledge and skills may not have to be perfect, but they can be good enough in order to produce and perform well enough, meet the standards, to produce outputs of value, worthy outputs that meet the standards. So that's what how I learned to look at performance improvement. Now, many people talk about this today is when they talk about performance improvement in a training or learning sense, they're talking about performance-based training or performance-based learning, and that's it, which is fine. That's what I do. I don't redesign processes, and I don't redesign information systems, and I don't redesign tools and equipment in order to make the performance go well. So I do work on that human slice of things, and I don't really do a lot with the, you know, what are the intellectual capabilities we're looking for and what are the psychological capabilities we're looking for. That's out of my domain. But I'm appreciative of all of that, and I have my own approach to look at that, decide, well, where's the variance here in this? And I try to help my clients avoid training when it's not necessary, when it's not going to do anything. Maybe you just simply need to fix the process, and then instead of training, maybe we need communications, which will create an awareness, or maybe we need education, which will create knowledge, or maybe we do need training or instruction to create skill. And so, you know, how do I get the biggest bang for the least effort and the smallest amount of dollars in order to affect performance? And so